Hi, welcome to the Brea Tar Pits. I'm Bo Campbell, a fossil preparator at the Natural History Museum in Los Angeles.
And I'm Sean Campbell. I'm a fossil preparator here at the Brea Tar Pits. We're here in Miracle Mile in Hancock Park, right along Wilshire Boulevard, and we're going to give you a behind-the-scenes tour back in the excavation complex. Here we are on Ogden Drive. This is the entrance and exit to the underground parking structure that LACMA, the art museum, our next-door neighbor in Hancock Park, decided to construct in 2006. When they did so, they found 16 new fossil deposits, which will end up being hundreds of thousands, if not more, fossils that we excavate out. Here we are in the excavation compound. On the north side, where we're at right now, we have the Project 23, and that is a bunch of fossil crates that came from the LACMA underground parking structure back in 2006. There were so many, and they were so large, that they actually had to be broken up into multiple boxes, and that's how we got the name for Project 23, because there was originally 23 crates associated with fossiliferous deposits uncovered about 15 to 25 feet down. And we've been excavating on them in this compound since 2008. We finished 8 of the boxes entirely. You don't even see them anymore because we broke them down after we measured out all of the fossils and collected all the matrix. Let's go take a look at box 13. This is box 13. So this was originally at about this level. And we've excavated it down to the point where we are now, and we've removed thousands of fossils in order to do so. And what we first do is we'll use hammers and chisels in sterile areas in the ground that are approaching the asphaltic portions of the deposit, and we'll chisel out this material relatively quickly because there's nothing in it. There's no fossils, so there's no worry about damaging anything. And then once we get into this black asphaltic mound full of remains that are all jumbled together, we'll use a chemical solvent known as N-propyl bromide. We'll apply it just in the area that we're working to help soften that material. Since they've been removed from the ground, the asphalt and the sediment have mixed and dried together so that it's now kind of a natural pavement. So now we have to apply those chemicals to break it down a little bit so it's safer to excavate and not break all the fossils that we are trying to uncover. In this, what we found in this box is a variety of everything, a huge diversity. So we have mammals, birds, insects, plants, all of that is coming out of this same area and it's all jumbled and mixed together. So we've got a mountain lion, multiple dire wolves and pups, saber-toothed cat, and a cub. We have a baby mastodon, maybe the most juvenile mastodon we've ever found at La Brea. We have bison and baby bison, horse and baby horse, dwarf pronghorn. We even have raccoons and rabbits and other types of rodents. And everything seems to be coming out of this deposit, which so far out of the few select specimens that we've been able to radiocarbon date, it's about 32,000 years old. But once we get more dates coming in and that get published, we know that that range is going to expand because usually a deposit is at least a few thousand years worth of accumulation, if not 10,000 years or more. So it can be highly variable how long each seep is coming up to the surface, collecting things. And then as sediment deposits over it, you get more and more and more as long as it stays active. When we excavate, we actually use a grid system. So I'm trying to show you here, I've laid out these meter sticks. So we're using metric now in Project 23. And north, we're gonna do a grid every meter. And going west, we're gonna do a grid every meter. So it's a meter square. And the level depths are gonna be 25 centimeters, which is about that. And the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna use hammers and chisels. And you can see in this area, that it's much lighter. There's no asphalt. You can see that black color isn't there. And also you can see that there's not fossils protruding out of that level. So we're gonna use hammers and chisels and we're gonna quickly go through those portions of the grid that are sterile and have no fossils. And then when we get to this area, the fossiliferous mound, we're still going to work in our grid system, and we're going to apply chemical solvent to soften up the material so it's safer to excavate through. And we're going to use dental tools and then brushes once it's dried to sweep all of that sediment mixed with asphalt or tar. And then it also contains teeny tiny little fossils, which will be processed in more chemicals later, and we'll find those under microscopes. So the entire ecosystem is really being preserved over the course of thousands of years, and it's all mixed together. But we're going to try and secure every single piece of evidence from the Pleistocene, from these deposits. So I'm going to point out a few fossils because I know that they're difficult to see, especially to the untrained eye, and they're covered in sediment and tar or asphalt, and they're very obscured. So I'm going to point a few of those out. So this is an ulna. An ulna is a forearm bone, and this is actually the elbow. And this is from a saber-toothed cat or Smilodon fatalis. And again, this is about 30,000 years old. This is the distal end of the humerus, potentially of that same saber-toothed cat, because it is also Smilodon fatalis, but it might be a different one and they just happen to be close to each other. This is an upper arm bone. This is also the elbow area. And then we have a coyote scapula right here. So a scapula is a shoulder blade. They're very thin. These are very difficult to excavate out because they're so thin. They tend to be broken along the blade. This is a vertebra. This is about direwolf in size. So Canis diris, thoracic vertebra. So it's one that attaches to ribs. And then we have large ribs. We've had a lot of ribs from this section, from the giant ground sloth, Paramylodon harlani. There's been a lot of giant ground sloth in this deposit. And then right next to that, we have tons of woody remains of branches and twigs and things like that. We have lots of different species of plants that are being preserved within these deposits as well. So truly it is the entire ecosystem being preserved. After we're done with the excavation process, the matrix or sediment grains that we excavate out, all that dirt and soil and sediment, that's all going to go into what we call matrix buckets. So 5-gallon buckets that are good for storage, because it takes us a long time to process through all this material. We use chemicals. So we use heated biodiesel and cold soak and N-propyl bromide, along with a sifter at the bottom of each bucket. And as the chemicals break down the asphalt, all the unconsolidated grains are loose and we can sift out the really fine silts and clays, and we're left with clean rocks and fossils. To show you a few, these are a little bit bigger because this was a salvage bucket from underneath one of the deposits, and they're easier to show to you all. But this is part of a bison. This is the teeth right here with part of the jawbone still attached. We have a bird femur. This is the femoral head that goes into the hip socket. As you can see, it's very hollow with struts. That's one of the ways you can identify it as a bird immediately. And then we also have a little turtle shell piece. So this is from the carapace, the top part of the shell, and it's called a peripheral plate because it's on the edge of the turtle shell. And so we have birds, turtles, bison in this deposit, and that's been cleaned out already. We're going to have other mostly carnivores, because these are carnivore traps. And I can see a lot of teeth in here. There's a lot of material, and it's all going to get sorted once we get it over into the lab. The largest deposit that we finished so far is box one. It was 123,000 pounds full of sediment, matrix, and fossils. And we've measured out tens of thousands of fossils from Project 23, with hundreds of thousands of small, teeny tiny fossils being found in that chemical processing and being sorted out in the lab. And we have a lot more to go. We've only finished 8 of the 23 boxes, and we're gonna keep excavating until we finish the entire project. Thanks for coming through, and I'll see you for the next video.